The Cabot development has been one of the most controversial developments taking place on the island. Sparking the controversy was the involvement of the National Insurance Corporation in its funding. Several individuals and groups have over the past 2 years voiced other concerns about the development, chief among the dissenters being the St. Lucia National Trust. One of their concerns was that of public access to the beaches along the Queen's Chain adjoining the development. Speaking on a local television program, Physical Development Minister Stephenson King disclosed that after reviewing the project and speaking with the various parties involved, Cabinet has taken the decision that the developers should not restrict public access to these beaches.
So in the overall development, there are two beaches, you know, them Secret and Donkey Beach. Very well known. Some St. Lucians don't know about it. But for the exploratory ones, we know Donkey Beach and Secret Beach. We have said to access those beaches, by virtue of the fact that all of the lands around those beaches are private, owned by Cabot now, the Queen's Chain must be released. And Cabinet has taken a decision on that. The Cazabar Beach, mm-hmm. where the famous Marjorie is located, etc., etc. Again, we have said that it cannot be touched.
And so Marjorie is not going to be moved.
Marjorie is not going to be touched. In terms of access to the beach, we have decided and taken a decision that the access will not be a footpath. It will be clearly a driveway, a road leading to the beach with parking and recreational facilities for the people of this country.
The government will also move to preserve areas which had been highlighted by the St. Lucia National Trust as being areas of archaeological interest. According to the Minister for Physical Development, whereas the current administration is fully committed to investment, those coming to invest must come with an understanding that the island's patrimony must be protected.
The Amerindian site and the other locations, all of those, we have decided that the leases on those will be returned to government. Government will take back these lands. And it's not intended in any way to prevent the developer from developing. We believe that notwithstanding that decision, the development can go on. The Cabinet has opined on it. We have looked at it and we've taken those decisions. We believe that we have done sufficient consultation, and I believe the developers, if they care in truth, must respect the position of the government and people of St. Lucia. I do not believe a St. Lucian can go to Miami and decide and go to the government in Miami and on Miami Beach and say, listen, I need you to close down that road. I want to put a hotel here, and everybody will have to pass around my hotel to get onto the beach.
The Cabot development, which covers some 300 acres of land, will, when completed, include an 18-hole golf course, a residential community, and a resort. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.